Hi Sagittarius, and welcome to my channel, The Guided Intuitive, and thank you so much for being here. So I'm going to do a read. This will be for June 1st through the 15th, 2019, and this will be for all Sagittarius sun, moon, rising, as well as your Venus signs, okay? Do keep in mind that this is a general read. It may not resonate with everyone. I do hope that there is something that you could take with you, if not, then leave it for another cross watcher or another Sagittarius that might be on a different level on their journey, okay? All right, so now, knowing that this is a general read, if you would like a private read, then go to theguidedintuitive.com and we will get you hooked up over there, okay? All right, so let's see what's going on. This is going to be for you and that other person, Sag. You I'm going to be talking about on one side and then the other person on the other. Feel free to interchange the messages on either side. You might resonate with more on one side than the other, you know, vice versa, or even a message, okay? So do note that, okay? Pretty normal there, all right? What else do you need to know? Please continue your likes, your subscribes, and shares. Guys, I really thank you so much for it. I hope you're enjoying your summer months. And you're experiencing some good times here. Oh my gosh. Okay, Sag, hold on a second, because I just dropped all the cards. Hold on a second. All right. Okay, so I hope that is not indicative of what's going on, because it could very much well be. You know, I noticed as I was kind of pre-shuffling, what kept coming through here is, you know, replay. And I guess what I mean by that, and what I was kind of backing that up, was that it's almost as if, like, what recurring situations are happening in my love life, okay, that consistently happen time after time again, what people am I, you know, attracting, you know, and what kind of lessons that they're giving you right now, you know, as it relates to that, and lessons about yourself, okay? So I would implore you to look into that. That's what I feel was coming through. Perhaps that has something to do with this read here, but you know, there is almost as if that there's something that's like replaying and like a tape. It keeps looping and looping, and it's a recurring situation in your life that I feel it keeps happening, and it has to do with something, a situation or people, a certain type of people that you're bringing into your life that you're seeing maybe perhaps a pattern now, and it could have to do with your love relationships, and this is a love read. So that's what's coming through here, and I'm itching, so I don't know, it's making me antsy. So I don't know, so you let me know and note your comments below, okay, Sag? All right, so let's see what wants to come through for you. I'm gonna go ahead and cut the cards now, and we will see what wants to come through here, okay? Here we go, here's the first one, let's see here. Okay, so you're carrying the burden, all right? You're really focused on, it's a 10 of wands, but this is about, you know, a lot of responsibility, and you might be taking the brunt of a responsibility in a particular relationship, a situation, you know, whatever that has brought you to my channel here right now. There's just, it's no coincidence, and that's what this is saying here, is that it's been a burden. Now, it is the 10, which means it's an ending, and it's moving on to a new beginning. So you're putting the burden aside now, and perhaps that is something that is one of those things in terms of a situations or a person. What that's telling about yourself is maybe you no longer want to carry the burdens anymore, not at least not all alone, okay? So, but that's what I'm getting here. Yeah, it's like the 10 of wands. And that's what's really coming through here. Yeah, it's about stress, exhaustion, just doing too many things, you know, as it relates. And it could be, you know, within a relationship that maybe you're doing all the work. And this is saying, you know, it's got to share some of that a little bit, you know, and that's what's coming into play here. So that's what I'm seeing. So let's see what else wants to come through for you here, okay? Okay, so we got the King of Wands. See, you're moving on up. You move from the Ten of Wands, and you move to the King. And the Kings are about authority, right? So this is really, really nice. I love seeing this. So yeah, that's what it's telling me, is that it's almost as if that you've now, this is like an entrepreneur. This is someone that is kind of taking hold of his or her domain at this particular time and really moving forward. But that's what I'm seeing here. Yeah, that's what I'm seeing. And it's almost as if they're seeing, you know, this king, This king is currently just really moving forward and, you know, really focused on the goals and seeing, you know, he's the king of his own castle, right? And I think now you've now done the hard work that you've now earned the placement as the king, you know, here. And this could be an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Again, this is your sign on both of these here. You know, the wands, talk about that. And keep in mind that the energies do trump the signs, you know, the astrological signs. I just bring that up because I know a lot of you like to hear that, but it is really more about the energy. This king could just as well be a you know, a queen, but what we're talking about here is that type of energy. So this that masculine, you know, kind of type energy here is what I'm seeing. So yeah, that's what I'm seeing coming through here. So very, very good. Very, very nice. Let's see what else wants to come out for you here. All right. Let's see here. Ooh, we've got the Five of Cups. So this is about, you know, focus on something that is in just focused on something that is no longer working for you, that has been a loss, emotional loss. And you feel that emotional loss. But what this is saying is that you're not done yet. This is a five. You've got two that are actually behind you, okay? And I don't know why it froze. The camera did something really crazy at that moment, but this is saying turn around. So this is saying quit freezing and looking at those particular cups and turn around. Okay, so that I think was that subliminal message I was going through here that happened, but that's what I'm seeing here. So it's about perspective, it's about, you know, stop, turn around. Okay, you've got two other cups that you need to focus on because there's some opportunities at hand as it relates to emotional fulfillment. And the fives, you know, are about, you know, adversity and things like that that were taking place. But yeah, that's what this is saying, is that really focus, turn around. There's a lot to be thankful for. You know, something was abandoned that you had to give up on, you know, some sort of grief, but let's see what else wants to come up for you, Sag, okay? So then we get the King of Swords. Wow. Okay, so this is carrying on that Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, or Venus type energy, and that's really standing back and taking on that energy and really getting rid of what no longer is going to be a purpose for you in your life. And you become a lot more stronger in that, and you've actually earned that positioning here, I think. And that's what's quite beautiful. Yeah, it's really, really beautiful. So carrying on the King of Swords is really, really key. And it's just all about, you know, authority. Yeah, it's all about your authority and taking the authority in your own love life and being in charge of that and really moving forward, you know, with what it is that you exactly want. You're very clear thinking, very intellectual, you know, at this point as it pertains to that. Yeah, it's like you had to walk away from something that wasn't working, and that's probably what you know, those cups that and the Five of Cups there. But it does take a lot of strength to walk away after a lot of investment that you made, Sag, in a particular relationship or situation. But here's the thing, you're moving forward, and it's almost as if that you are offering a cup of love to someone, or someone's offering a cup of love to you. This is the Knight of Cups. This is about motion, moving forward. And this is about real pure thoughts. You've got that white horse, right? And it's almost as if it's going this way and the other person's going to be on this side. So that's why I'm bringing that up. And it's almost as if you're moving forward with that confidence and what it is that you want. You've got energy, passion. This is about adventure, right? This is about lust. This is about, you know, kind of going that route. But it looks like you're giving your cup of love to someone here, right? You want something that is emotional balance. You get the Temperance, okay? It's almost as if that you were kind of balancing, pouring into one cup and then the other, pouring into one cup and the other. And that's, you know, kind of what you were doing in order to maintain your sanity of keeping the burden of everything going here. But I think now that you've now have your place in terms of, you know, the King of Wands and the King of Swords kind of type energy, I really feel that you're balancing things out and you've balanced your emotions out in terms of moving forward, being more clear on what it is that you want in your love life. Okay. Yeah. And then it's funny is that you're offering a cup of love to someone, it really looked like, and coming from the other side is that someone was offering a cup of love to you. And this could be a Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, Sun, Moon, or Rising, but that's the way I'm seeing it as it's facing each other here. So, it's almost as if someone's coming in with that, with a Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, Sun, Moon, or Rising, or Venus type energy that's offering you. And it's a page, and pages are all about messages, right? But it is about, you know, it's about being, you know, synchronicity, right? You know, getting synchronicity, you know, getting that synchronicity with someone and having creativity and moving forward that's making you feel emotionally good. Let's check out this other person. What's going on with them? Okay. They get the Page of Wands. Lots of new beginnings. So on this side, they also have a, is a page. And this is all about, you know, they are embodying this discovery. You know, they're on this new discovery and they're starting all over. So it's almost as if there's this new discovery that's coming within them. They're very enthusiastic. So it's like a beginning and having a lot of passion, you know, towards this new beginning. So that's this other person. Let's see what else wants to come out for this other person. The Hangman. Yeah. So the Hangman's coming into play here. And when I see this, what this is telling me is that, you know, they're just trying to, they're getting a different perspective. They're where they want to be in terms of getting their creativity. They want a different perspective as it relates to a new beginning. And as they go forward in that, they're actually looking long term, you know, what that is. You know, threes are all about communication. So there could be communication about a new perspective that launches a new beginning. Okay. And that's on this other side over here. Okay. So new beginning, looking long term, right? And this is all about, yeah, this is really just about preparation, being prepared and what they want in a relationship long term. So let's see what else wants to come through for this other person. World. So this is a completion. Yeah, they went through a completion with this new beginning, right? And this is nice because this is a major arcana card for them. And it is a completion, which brings them to the new beginning, which makes them want to look further out there. And again, try a different perspective on what that looks like. Yeah, I think that they came from the past, which is more of a devil type energy, which again, could have been a Capricorn. Whether they were embodying it or perhaps if there was anything like that here. But I think that they are starting a new beginning and getting rid of anything that was toxic with them previously. So note your comments below, guys, if you know that that kind of pertained to you. But it was very, yeah, they felt bound to something or someone or something. And that's what I was feeling here, okay? And yeah, and I get, I get the King of Pentacles, okay? So what I get the signs on this side is that it's more about the Aries, Leo, Sagittarius and something that was toxic. But they are moving forward. It could have had to do with a Capricorn, okay? A Capricorn that had, you know, a new, it's almost as if they're starting brand new, but what was toxic was with a Capricorn of some sort. So I don't know, but that's what I feel was coming over on this side for this person, right? And I think that they're becoming very disciplined and now they're moving forward being very decisive. They are moving forward with strong, you know, very good in business, right? Be able to make good decisions. And I think that this person is taking on that type of energy. But I do think that in their relationship, they're really taking control and using their head a little bit more than anything. Yeah, and they had to go through and make it and figure out, you know, what decision that they're going to make. You know, in terms of a situation. Yeah, it could have been, yeah, they had to make a decision as as it relates to something in their life. And it's about getting rid of a Capricorn and starting new or staying with it. So the decision, yeah, they decided to go on a whole new journey and make it the Fool's journey. So this person is going on a brand new journey in the Fool. And this is nice because this is about new beginnings, okay? And I'm not surprised to see that because what came out at the very, very beginning. And that would be interesting because I almost feel like this cup, like I said, it's almost as if that you're offering this. And when I look at this, it's kind of offering each other. They're offering this to you and you're offering this to them. It's a very, it's a cup of love of some sort. So it may not be the case for both of you here, but there is a new beginning on this side. And with that new beginning, oh, wow. With that new beginning, the next card that they get is the Ten of Pentacles. Okay. So they're looking for their happy ever after. This is what they want. Their new beginning is focused on manifesting and getting this Ten of Pentacles. Okay. That's what I see here. Yeah, that's what I see. A new beginning with the Ace of Wands. Okay. So it's coming through here. And the Ace of Wands tell me it's all about, you know, it is about inspiration and creativity, a new beginning overall. Okay. So let's see what it is that you want to say to them, Sag, and what this other person wants to say to you. Okay. Let's see what that is. Okay. I didn't get any, you know, I got a new beginning on your side as well. And just note your comments and what you feel that, you know, your loss in terms of a relationship, there was some sort of loss or sadness as it relates to the, you know, that. But there are offers of love that are coming through here. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, or Venus. It could be also dealing with Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, or Venus, okay? Carrying on that type of energy. So what it is that you want to say to them is, right now, I do not need a lecture. I need your love. Okay, so that's what this is saying. It's like, remember I saw this other person on this side was coming forward with a lot of intellect. They were kind of taking on that emperor type energy. So that's what I feel. And even though there might be a new beginning, there might be, you know, some decisions that have to be made in terms of how to communicate. But this is really beautiful. This is very well intentioned, and it's really the highest expression of love. Just saying, hey, I don't need a lecture. I just really want to focus on dropping from the head into the heart. Okay, and we need to start there. Okay, start there, and that's the best place to start regaining to a relationship. So, what is it that they would like to say to you? Let's see here what that is. Okay, it feels like I can do no right by you. Okay. So that's what this is saying. So this is interesting, because, this is when, this person is sending this because they think that they are, that you're not liking them in some way. Okay. And it can range from, not actively, you know, being their cheerleader or maybe perhaps it's you unwilling to give an inch in a situation. But this is just saying is that this person is just saying is that, it's like this person just really feels you don't like them. And that's what they're feeling at this moment. So let's continue. Let's pull a couple more cards and pull one more for you, Sag. What is it you want to say to them? Oh, wow. It's hard admitting I might be wrong. Yeah, it takes a lot of guts to do this, but it's also very humble and it really enriches the relationship. What happens to be a problem is when you are fighting to be right in a relationship, because that does not bring in love. Okay, so I think this is so cool that you're doing this, that this is true, is that admitting you might be wrong brings that humbleness and brings that fertile ground for an opportunity or something to be planted, so it can sprout in a much better way, maybe perhaps that as it was before. Let's see what they would like to say to you. Okay, let's see what that is. Okay, your behavior embarrassed me. I'm trying to tell you, not to make you feel bad, but so I can feel close to you again. So that is what is coming up. So maybe something, Sag, that they feel that said, did, or whatever the situation is, had burdened them in some way or kind of triggered them in some way, perhaps as it relates to, something in the past for them, was sensitive and shining the light. And it's saying, obviously the goal is to feel close to you, and that is key, which is so admirable. That's so beautiful. And that should be the key focus. And it's not blaming one another on something. That's saying, because of this, this is how I was feeling. And it's not, I'm not saying to point it out at you. I'm just saying, hey, it's just, I just want to get closer to you. So nice. So what's going to help in the overall process of this? Let's pull some final cards, and then we're going to see overall, what are some maybe final words? Just one word that, one word cards that are going to help this situation that could really soothe it and bring a lot more ease. Okay. So what is that? Courage. So having the courage to stand up, the courage that you had, Sag, that, hey, sometimes it's hard to admit that I might've been wrong, I don't need a lecture. I just need your love. So it could be the courage enough to say that, right? So that's really key. And also for them too, is to even bring that up. You know, I'm pointing this out that this embarrassed me, but at the same time, it's all because I just want to feel close to you. So let's see. So that's one thing. And this stems from the spirit, and it's also about passion. So it comes from, the crown chakra as well as the root chakra, right? And it's bringing light in that. It's bringing them both together, bringing the light to the situation. So what else? Let's see what wants to come through here. Here it is. companion. Is this companion? Companion, nice. Two people coming together, right? And it's kind of meshing the branches together. And this is about communication. All this blue here is about the throat chakra, which is blue, which is about communication, whether in person, in text, whatever that is. This is saying is that, you know, to bridge that gap. Sometimes there's some unknowns, and that's why I use these cards to help kind of put words to feelings that might help you start that kind of conversation, you know, if that opportunity does arise, okay? So companion is very, very nice. So to have a companion does take good communication, right? Anything else? Shine, okay? So this is beautiful. So just having the courage, you know, having the courage to step forward, right? Having the courage to step forward and have that communication, right? Have that communication so you two can grow and thrive and get the, you know, reach all the light that's above here. And then you can actually shine on. So that's beautiful. What a beautiful way to end, guys, okay? So this is about passion, right? It's also spirituality and gaining confidence as it relates to the relationship or situationship, whatever that is, as a whole, okay? And if you decide to go on your own way, you know, it is bringing this to some sort of, clarity, you know, if you can. You know, this is the best way that the cards are seen to kind of bring about that. So we'll see. So note your comments below, guys. I look forward to seeing you in the second half of July. And until then, namaste.